The parcels and letters possibly drying up. And some cities broadcasters finding out.
Canada Post and the Canadian Union of Postal Workers have been without a contract since late 2015, and the two sides remain far apart. But it seems not too many people are concerned about a labor stoppage.
My accounts are online, so I pay my accounts online. It won't affect me really much.
Do you use that actually quite a bit, but I'm not especially worried because I use it for pleasure mail.
Most of my stuff's online as well.
Canada Revenue Agency says OAS and CPP checks are deemed essential and will be delivered even during a labor disruption. I'm Rob Hunter.
Most Canadians think the UK's choice to Brexit the European Union was a bad move. But 680's John Ackerman reports they don't think it will have much of an impact on relations between our two countries.
That's the takeaway from a new Main Street research poll. In fact, only 17% think Britain leaving the EU will be bad for Canada, while just 11% feel it'll be a good thing. Keto Maggie with Main Street says we have stronger views about Britain's Prime Minister.
In terms of David Cameron, Canadians, 42% approve of David Cameron versus 53%, which is approved just 12%. We're not sure.
Support for Brexit appears higher in Quebec, with only a slim majority opposed to Britain leaving the EU. I'm Joe Ackerman.
680 News Time 209. We're 30 seconds away from a check on gas prices.
Vaughn Mills reminds you that even a few minutes in a hot vehicle can be deadly to your pets. On summer days, vehicles can quickly reach deadly temperatures, even with the car parked in the shade and the windows slightly open. Keep your pet's safety in mind. If you can't take them with you when you leave your car, leave them at home. Please visit nohotpets.ca and pledge not to leave your pets in your vehicle. A reminder from Vaughn Mills and the Ontario SPCA, who remind you, don't forget your pet.
I'm now with the 680 News gas price update. Enbro predicts the price of gas will not change at midnight, holding at 106.9 cents a liter at most GTA stations.
In a great while, London and Broadway celebrate something extraordinary. For now, it's Toronto's turn. Matilda, the musical. Experience Time Magazine's number one show of the year. Matilda, the musical. Arrives next week at the Edmonds Theatre. For tickets, call 416-872-1212 or book at Mervish.com.
Working at heights, training requirements are the law in Ontario. If you're an employer who has workers who work at heights in construction, make sure they're trained. If you're a homeowner, hiring a contractor who will have workers working at heights, such as replacing a roof, you should ask if they have the training and how they'll work safely. To find out more, visit ontario.ca/workingatheights. Paid for by the Government of Ontario.
680 News Time 211. Traffic and weather together on the ones. Let's get an update from Christine Michaels.
This report is brought to you by GTA BMW Retailers. If you're on the eastbound 401, we have some volume from east of the 427 to west and alternately express and collectors. But I had a look at the westbound 401. We are hearing about a problem just approaching Bathurst, but I'm not spotting anything on the cameras whatsoever and no delays to point out. Westbound 401 is in good shape, even through Mississauga into Milton, no troubles. Northbound Don Valley Parkway, problem free. Southbound 400 is closed from south of Shepherd as you make your way onto the westbound 401 ramp, which is down to a single lane because of construction. Southbound 404 Don Valley is busy from Shepherd in the collectors to the 401 ramp after approaching the 401 in the express to Lawrence. On the westbound 3W approaching Guelph Line, we had a disabled vehicle blocking the center lane. Looks like it's slowed down from about Rocky to Grant, and then Fort Erie bound QEW is still heavy, approaching Vermont Street out the street, rather, into the Grimsby area. Now, we do have construction which just closed westbound Dundas Road to northbound 427, but not spotting any delays on the 427 north or southbound. Eastbound Gardner just a bit slow at the Spadina ramp, but again, no problems on the Gardner Expressway. Fields is closed west of Weston Road both ways because of a serious collision. And for the night march this afternoon, keep in mind that Bloor is closed from Yonge to Church. Yonge is closed from Carlton to Bloor, and Carlton is closed from Yonge to Jarvis until about 6 this evening. Don't just drive, drive a legend. Get rates from 0.9% plus a $1,500 credit at the BMW 3 Series, a month-long sales event until July 3rd. Now with a check of the forecast, here's meteorologist Brian Hill.
Well, Christine, it's great. It's going to stay that way. Beautiful mixture, sun, cloud, breezy, northwesterly wind, and a guaranteed high 25. UV index very high. Tonight, mainly clear. The winds will die off. The low 14, great for the big ride tomorrow. It'll be mainly sunny at 27. And then Monday, being mainly sunny. And highs near 30 degrees. And for Tuesday and Wednesday, downtown at 680 is 24, Pearson 26. That makes us the warmest place in Ontario right now at 26. Northwesterly winds at 36, gusting at 58. Our guaranteed high today, 25.
680 News Time 213. With Canada Day taking place yesterday and the Trump campaign for U.S. president causing some Americans to think about moving up north, it seems people around the world are curious about Canada. What are they wondering about? 680's Andrew Whalen has the details.
According to Google, here are the top five questions the world is asking about Canada. How to move to Canada? What time is it in Canada? What is the capital of Canada? Is weed legal here in Canada? And where is Fort McMurray? And here's something interesting. Alberta ranks third among provinces searching for details about Canada Day fireworks behind British Columbia and Nova Scotia.
Coming up in international news, a famous Brooklyn pizza parlor's owner is killed in a botched robbery.
I thought we'd stay in self-inflicted and want to give you the opportunity to enjoy it. Simplify and enhance your lifestyle with automated window coverings powered by Snuffy. All it takes is a push of a button, and you have control over your blinds, shades, and drapes. And when you're not at home, a wireless timer automatically sets your coverings in motion when the sun is too bright or when you'd like increased security. Your children will stay safe. To locate a Comfy Expert retailer near you, go to comfysystems.com. SONFYSystems.com.
Ken Chatham's chicken wing eating champion and an escaped pet python from Parkdale help promote your business? Definitely. How? It's local news, and local news matters. Metroland Media has over 100 local papers, 40 digital properties, and the largest flyer network in Ontario, making them the most read and trusted source of local advertising. In fact, 90% of people in their communities turn to their publications for local news and shopping information. To turn those readers into customers, visit Metroland.com today. Metroland Media. Connected to your community. This is on News Radio, 680 News.
We're mainly clear sky and 24 degrees in downtown Toronto. Good afternoon from the 680 News Broadcast Center. I'm Jack Rowe. Here are the top stories this hour. The 20th annual Psych March is just about underway along Bloor Street, heading from Church to Yonge, south to Carlton, east to Allen Gardens, with a 5,000 in attendance. Have an afternoon of celebration and entertainment. Witnesses to a shooting last night at an Aurora banquet hall are being asked to step forward. Three women and a man were wounded, with their conditions ranging from serious to non-life-threatening. 680 News Time 215. Time now for 680 Sports from Sportsnet 590. The Fan. Here's